Sure, the FR-AV2 is the ultimate audio interface for videographers. But is it possible to record audio timecode, LTC, into an iPhone or iPad video file? Absolutely, and it may be even easier than you think. Before we get started, your iPhone or iPad will need to have a USB-C port to work properly. Next, make sure your FR-AV2 has firmware version 1.03 or higher. If not, head to the product page on the TASCAM website to download and install the firmware updater software. All right, let's move on and record LTC into an iPhone. Enter the menu on the FR-AV2, then scroll down to Timecode and press Enter. At the top of the screen, we see frame rate, which can be changed to accommodate the demands of the project. For the master clock setting, this should be set to internal. Just below that, we can physically see the timecode value and that it's currently running. However, we can always use a custom timecode value. By entering the custom menu, we can set our values however we'd like. Press Restart when ready. Another option is to use the time of day. If this option is desired, press Restart to make the change. Next is the TC out level, which we'll want to set to mic for this project. Once our changes have been made, press back until we find ourselves on the home screen. We'll find our TC out and TC in 3.5mm jacks on the bottom panel of the FR-AV2. We'll need to connect those together with a stereo mini jack audio cable. After that, enter the input menu. For channel 1, change the input to external. Now we can see the timecode input level coming from TC out to TC in. Now we'll connect our microphone to channel 2 with an XLR cable. In this video, we're using a shotgun mic, so we'll need to engage phantom power from the channel 2 input menu. Here we can see the timecode input on the left side of the meter, and the audio input from our mic on the right side of the meter. Both the left channel and the right channel will eventually be sent to the iPhone via USB-C. However, when monitoring the audio through headphones, the timecode signal is going to be overpowering. So let's take a look at how to monitor our audio without the TC signal. Enter the output menu and scroll down to solo. Enter that menu and select channel 2 and press enter. Now, our audio monitoring will be strictly limited to our microphone input, cutting out any timecode signal. Now, our settings on the FR-AV2 are complete. If this is a step we may use a lot in the future, we can save everything as a user preset so that we can get back to this at any time. Enter the menu, then scroll down to Other Settings. From here, select Save under the User Settings tab and press Enter. Select any user setting that we'd like, press Enter, and then Confirm. Those settings can now be recalled at any time with the Load option. For the next step, we'll connect our FR-AV2 to an iPhone 16 Pro with a USB-C cable. Here, we're using an app called Filmic Pro. In the app, navigate to the Settings menu and then select Audio. We can see that the FR-AV2 is set to the audio interface, and our sample rate and bit depth are set to 48K, 24-bit. While the FR-AV2 can handle 32-bit float, most video apps aren't set up to utilize such a high bit depth. But we can always record 32-bit float directly to the SD card in our FR-AV2 simultaneously. Going back to the settings in our app, make sure our video parameters, such as frame rate, are set to match what we input into our interface earlier. Now we can see the audio signal coming through the meters in our app. Again, timecode signal in the left channel, our microphone signal in the right channel. By default, the TC signal is set to negative 12 dB. But it's worth noting that sometimes video editing software cannot detect the timecode if the volume is set too high or too low. Now we're all set to start recording. We'll hit record on the app, then again on the FR-AV2. When it comes to audio for videographers, the FR-AV2 has you covered from professional audio quality to a whole host of timecode options. Click the link on the screen for more tutorials on the FR-AV2. And as always, be sure to hit like and subscribe to be notified when we post new videos.